to concentrate on the theory of Cantor's 16 PF trait theory. The 16 PF represent personality factor. What is 16 PF in the sense? Why he coined the term 16 PF in the sense? In the case of the Alford, he divide the traits into four components or four factors. But in the case of the Cantor, he feel that the Alford classification is very small. It is not correct. And also the last class we discussed, no, I mentioned that Alford, he combined more than 4,500 dictionary words, vocabularies related to the personality traits. Then after that, he combined all the traits, all the 4,500 words to four components into different traits approaches. Okay. But what he believed in the sense, Cantor, what he believed, his way of thinking is to be totally different of the Alford, because how we can combine only the four components or four factors. That is why he extended the theory of Alford and Eisenach. Even the Eisenach also, the next class we may discuss about Eisenach. The Eisenach, he may come to the types and trait approach. He concentrated on, he shared that only the three way we have to classify people, like that he suggested something. But the cat is having some kind of different opinions about the both the people, Alford as well as the Eisenach. So he having some kind of broad visions, we cannot go with the limited number of traits. It's better to go with more than nearly 16 factors. And he attempted and he divided these factors with the use of the statistical techniques that is called factor analysis. So these things only we are going to talk about here. I already mentioned that each traits have the two different end, like the positive end and so the negative end. If you take the honesty as one trait in the sense, we have the honesty at the two different end. Some people are very honest, some people are very poor to keep the honesty. Therefore, all the traits, all the characteristics of the people having the two different end. This is only it's talking that. So when I discussing about the trait, I talked about the bipolar. So for each trait having the bipolar directions only. So each end having. Before going to deeply about the Cantor, just I'm brief about the who is Cantor. He is the man Cantor. His name is Raymond Cantor. He was born in 20th March 1905 in the Birmingham, England. He is an originator in England. He died in 2nd April 1998 at the age of 92. See, he lived in more than in the world is 92 years after 90 years. The nationality is British and American. His alma mater. This is nothing but where he did the courses and all, where he did finish some of the courses or the programs. He's basically, he did everything in the King's College, London. And he's contributed a lot of things to the society. And his remarkable contribution, only 16 PF personality factors. Then second one is called fluid and crystallized intelligence and culture for intelligent test. And hopefully you know, sir, who is the spearman? Who is the spearman? Anyone can know? What is the contribution of the spearman? What is the contribution of the spearman? Anyone can know the spearman contributions into the education sector? What kind of theory he given to us? Spearman, when you think about the spearman, immediately we can recall the two-factor theory. But the spearman, he may be a psychologist, but he did a lot of contribution in the case of the statistics. And now we are using the correlation of Pearson product moment correlations and rank correlation and all. From this, the rank correlations made by the spearman only. Therefore, the rank correlation, we will keep the term as here, spearman rank correlation. And he is the man to start the lot of works in the statistics. And he did a lot of contribution to factor analysis. I hope some of the science background people, you can know what is a factor analysis. Factor analysis in the sense, we can combine the lot of statement into the different components. Like suppose I have the 100 questions. All the 100 questions we may treat it as here, each variables. But instead of going with the 100 dimensions, the factor analysis may helping us to combine all the 100 dimensions to 10 dimensions. it means we can combine. So it means that all the 10 dimensions having 10 questions. For that purpose, we are using the factor analysis. In the factor analysis, if you deeply look on it, in the factor analysis structure, you can understand what is the confirmative factor analysis, the exploratory factor analysis. These are things you may learn in the next semester when you learn the statistics paper. But this semester, you don't have statistics. That's why I'm skipping that area. But lot of contribution the Spearmans did in the case of the correlation as well as the statistical things. But in what way the Raman catalyst linked with him, in the sense, he's a follower of the catalyst, a follower of the Spearman. He worked a lot of things along with Spearman. That is why his statistical contributions, it make them to lead the his future researchers in the statistics part. So that is why he made lot of contributions in the case of the statistics as well as the personality. But all the personalities as well as the intelligence theory he coined based on the factor analysis or some kind of correlation techniques with the use of facts only he made it. This is a small introduction about the cattle. As I move to the next slides. So as we already know that he was born in 1905. Cattle witnessed the advent of many 20th century inventions such as electricity, telephones, cars, and airplanes, because he was alive that particularly in 20th century only. He admired about the science things. It's nothing but he was, it means that he was inspired by these innovations and was eager to apply the scientific methods used to make such discoveries to the human mind and the personality. That is his inspiration. So he liked to do the or incorporating the science method for discovering the human minds of the personality. That's why he attempts some kind of scientific calculations of the factor analysis or the correlation techniques for categorizing the people based on the personality. And the personality, he believed that was not just some unknowable or untestable mystery. It was something that could be studied and be organized. Through the scientific study, human characteristics and behavior could be predicted based on underlying personality traits. So he believed like this only. So he strongly believed that the scientific method, when he incorporating to finding the people's personality, it may helping to understand the exact, it may helping to divide the personality factors into some kind of different components. That is why he much involved in the scientific method to incorporate people's kind of personality traits. And Cattle worked, I already mentioned that Cattle worked with the psychologist Charles Spearman, who was known for his pioneering work in statistics. Cattle would later use the factor analysis techniques developed by Spearman to create his own personality taxonomy. I already mentioned that he's having the some kind of deviations opinion from the Albert, because the Albert having the 4,500 what is this? 4,500 vocabularies he found from the dictionary. After this only he coined this kind of studies, no? But he is having some kind of negative notion about the particular theory of the Albert. That's why he moved to the 16 PF based theories. Just I'm going to highlight the theories. What is the 16 PF? What he did in this is he may collect the data from the different sources. Generally, he divide he collect the data into three different sources of the people in the category. One is called T data, Q data, as well as the L data. There is a difference between the all the data. L data represent it is the life record data, such as school grades and absence from work, etc. In the case of the research, we may use the term as the secondary data. So some of the secondary data may be available, some kind of recorder. That recorder also he may use for to find out the people's personality. And the second data is called as a Q data. What is the Q data? In the sense, questionnaire based. We have to give questionnaire to these samples. If the sample responded, the based on the sample respondent, we can make it some kind of classification of the personality traits. So he used this methods for much in the case of to find to divide the people's personality. And the third one is called T data. The T data is like objective based test. And also it may help to test design to tape into the personality construct. It may helping for them to construct the test in a perfect manner. Therefore, these two data he used for dividing his theory into 16 factors. This theory, I may highlight here. This is the theory he made it. See here. And also, what is the uniqueness? No, he is having the nearly 160 items. Nearly 160 items. All the 160 items, he ran with factor analysis statistics techniques. There's a factor analysis, lot of running procedure out there, like the Varimax and other things. You may understand in the next semester, in the third semester. Based on the statistic analysis of the 160 statement, he combined all the 160 statement into the 10 different components or 10 different, 16 different factors. That different factors, he coined the name as a warm, reasoning, emotional stability, dominance, liveliness, rule consciousness, sociableness, sensitiveness, vigilance, abstractness, privateness, apprehensions, openness, self-reliance, perfectionism, and tension. So this is a 16 components he divide based on the 160 questions which he used for the data collections. So I already mentioned that he did the data collection with the use of questionnaire. From the questionnaire of the 160 statement, he went for the statistic analysis. From the 160 questions, it may combine into the 16 components. That 16 components only he listed like this. And during the examination, it should be memory only, because you cannot be recall, you cannot be apply it at anywhere. It should be memory based only, this theory. Better to be memory this, the order of this. If you not keeping the order, it's not an issue, but at least you should know what are the 16 factors he made it after the factor analysis of his board. And the advantage of the each factors which he made it, no, there is a some kind of 8-point scale based he may divide it, like invent, he may use the term as 16 PF. So we already used those. 16 PF is nothing but 16 personality factors, and PF personality factors. Some people may use the term as inventory. Some people may use the term as a questionnaire. So there is a small difference between the inventory and questionnaire. In the case of the psychology, we are using the term as a inventory somewhat to be more apt in the case. And the advantage of the each factors, no? He divide the each factors into the some kind of descriptors, but the descriptor having the two different end. What is called low range as well as the high range. As we already knows, no, there is a bipolar process. I already told that all the traits are in the bipolar traits only, factor of it. The same approach. In the case of the warmth, if you are taking the considerations, the low level is called reserved, the high level is called outgoing. It means that they are reserved people like introvert. The outgoing people are extrovert. The outgoing people are very sociable, very funny. Okay, but in the case of the reserved people, they won't mingle to others and all. So they're very much private. Okay, they live for themselves only. So that is the difference you can find it from the warm. There is a two different there. In the case of reasoning is, you already know that it's related to the cognitive functions. In this, the reasoning ability, he divided in two different there. One is for less intelligence, some kind of more intelligent. But even though some people may be moderate level also. That is why what he did know. So in the level of high to low, he made it into, there is a 8-point scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 8. So up to 8. There is a 8 classifications of the outgoing, of the warm. Suppose the people are clicking the 4 or 5, it means that they are a moderate level of warm. If the people are clicking the 5 in the case of the reasoning, it means that they have the moderate level of intelligence. So like this, we can come from the conclusion about whether they are having the low range descriptor or high range or the moderate level. So in this manner, we can classify the people into each factors with three levels, low, moderate, high. Then in the case of the emotional stability, low level is called affected by feelings. In the high level, it's called emotional stable. In the moderate level, he knows what it is doing. In the case of dominance, it's called humble, is the low level. In the case of high level, it's called assertive. In the case of liveliness, the low level is called sober. And the high level is called happy to go lucky. In the case of the rule consciousness, the low level is called expedient. High level is called concentratedness. In the case of social boldness, the low level is called shy. High level is called venturesome. In the case of sensitiveness, the low level is called tough-minded. high levels called tender minder. Then vigilance, the low levels called sustained, higher levels called suspicious. In the case of the abstractness, the low level people are practicum based, they're doing. In the case of the high level, they are very much imagined. They have a lot of creativity. In the case of the privateness, the low level is called straightforward. In the case of the high level is called skew. In the case of the apprehension factor, the low range descriptors are like the self-assured. High level is called apprehensive. Similarly, the openness to change is called conservative. The low level, experimenting is high level. In the case of self-reliance, group dependent is a low level, self-sufficient is a high level. Then perfectionism in the case of the lower range is called self-conflict, high level is called self-control. Similarly, the tension, the low level is called relaxed. So the people's not worried about anything, they're very much relaxed. Some people always have the tension. Some people having the moderate level of tension. Okay. So from his theory, what we can understand in the sense, he may divide into 16 personality. Into the factors, but each 16 personality factors is talking about the three levels. One level is called low level of the warm or low level of each factors, and the extreme end is called high level, the moderate and the middle end is called moderate level. So this is his own contributions based on the statistical techniques of the factor analysis. He divided the 160 component, 160 items into 16 personality factors. The same thing only I'm highlighting here as a factors. But the terms which he used, no, see here the A, B, C, D, E, F, I, J, K, L, M, and O. After this, he's using the Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Because it is like a general component, it also may connect with somewhere in this particular factors. So that is why he used the different numbers A to O. After this, it means that 1 to 12, he's using the alphabetical number, alphabetical things A to O. After this, the 13, 14, 15, 16 uses A. Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. This is a contribution. The same order only. Warmth, reserved, outgoing, reasoning, less intelligent, more intelligence, emotion stable, affected feeling, emotion stable, dominance, humble, assertive. But the problem here, the people are using the different terminology when they describe it here. Because each of the psychologists, when they adopting the his theory, Cattell's theory, he changed this terminology as they flexible for them. So that is why in the case of here, in the previous slide, you can see the different terms, reserve or going here, they're using. Some of the terms is not match as it is from the different people. Some kind of different, but it's a small deviation happened. But in the case of the warm, factors should be same for all the personal, all the psychologists, those who are following this one, those who are adopting this theory. And the next thing, the same thing only, but here I'm giving some kind of different explanations here. So with the time, I can skip this one. So even this PowerPoint, this particular slide, you may understand exactly what is A. So A is represent warm. The warmth, here they represent only the reserved and outgoing only. But here they given the different things, cool, reserved, impersonal, detached, formal, and all of, like that different lot of terminology they provided. And in the case of the high score, outgoing, kindly, participating, like people. So sometimes you could not understand the some words mean like a sober and all, but that is why the other psychologists, those are following his theory, they given some kind of other description, like suppose you are not meant with some word experience, then if you read the other terms, you can understand the meaning of the particular factors. That's why some of these personal psychologists, those who are adopting this theory, they may give some kind of brief explanation about this theory. That's why you are giving some kind of different names in here. And this is a unique diagram. So see this diagram here, the ABC. This is like normally we may use in the case of the structural equation modeling, the case of statistics. This is called structural equation model. In the structural equation modeling, after the factor analysis, he attempted this kind of factor structural equation model. From this, you could understand that each factor, they're having some kind of interrelation with other factors too. Each factor having a relation with other factors. See this case, the first factor is warm. It may connect with the impulsiveness, with boldness, as well as the self-reliance. So that's why I told the yellow color, the Q2 is somewhat related to the A, H, F, and N. In the case of the Q3, the blue color, it may link with conformity. It's a G. In the case of the Q4, that L color, the red color, that's why the Q3, Q4, they use the different term. It may directly link with insecurity as well as the emotional stability. The last Q1, in the case of Q1, it is related to openness. It may connect with sensitivity. So like each components or each factors, they may interconnect with each other. In this, you can see some of the lines. In this lines, you can see some of the lines are very thick. Some of the lines are very thin. So the thick lines represent there is a high level correlations happen between the variables, the two variables or two components. In the, so for example, the boldness and dominance, the lines are not that much of thing. It's very lean. It's not thick. Therefore, it having some kind of relationship, but not in a much high level positive relationship. That is why they make it a very small lean line and not a thick line. If whenever you find the thick line, it means that there is a very high level correlation happened between the two components. So from this diagram representation, you can understand exactly how the each factors may link with each other. So even he divided the 16 factors on factors, but all the factors may link with each other according to this theory. And this is the same thing I already mentioned, you know, in the case of the warmth, reserved, outgoing. But he divided the people into 8 levels. But the 8 levels we may treat it into low, moderate, high only. For example, in the case of the 4 and 5, we can take the case 4 and 5 is the moderate level of the factors. In the case of the 1, 2, 3, they are the low. In the case of 6, 7, 8, they are highs. For example, I'm observing you, some of the people. I'm observing the Kavita. Suppose the Kavita score comes to 7 in the case of the first warmth. It means that she's outgoing. So in the case of the intelligence, the Kavita is like 5. So I can come for conclusion that she made the moderate level of intelligence. So this is some kind of measuring the people's personality. So the same tools, still the people's, a lot of people are using for the research purpose. Just I'm moving to the extension of this theory. Yes, please.
Sir, actually, who is doing the rating? We are the psychologist.
Yeah, of course, you suppose we are doing the research. You want to find out the personality of your students. What you have to do, you can use this kind of tool. There's a 160 statement. If you come to the department, I will show the tool. There is a book is there and with the tool. If I give the tool, the students may fill the responses, all the 160 items. Then after that, we can combine from the researcher or the teacher side, you have to combine into this kind of format, like whether the first 10 items, it may talking, it may highlighting only the warmth only. From this, all the 10 items he put like this, that led to 6 to 7, 8 only. It means that in the warmth category, it may be outgoing. Suppose the second component of the less intelligence, he given the respondent, most of the scores lies in this level, you can treat him as a low level of intelligence guy. Like that, we can confer any kind of interpretation based on the responses which the students made. I hope you understand, no? The observation we can do, the calculation we can do, but the respondent may respond it once you give the questionnaire, right? Like, I hope some of the people already given, some of the researchers, those are attending EMBED, no, last year, they may give to some of the questions during your BEd times. You may take, no? You may take and give to them. Like some people may use the questionnaire or some kind of tools. So once you are the sample in the case. Suppose once some persons are giving some question to you, you are the sample. Once you give the respondent, after that you are giving to them, giving to them, then they go to the home, they may do some kind of calculations. The calculation summary like this only. So they may categorize you into different components. Particularly, they connect with this kind of personality factors in the sense. So here, both the respondents is important. One is the students or your sample respondent. Once you give the questionnaire, they may pick it. Then they may hand out to you. After that, you have to do some kind of calculations. Whether the first component of the this one, what is the warmth, in what level he is there. In the intelligence, and there is... in the case of reasoning, what is the level? Like that, we can come for each dimension-based conclusions. that we have to do. Yes. Now, the extension of the theory, it's not extension, but we can divide the 16 constant factor into the four unique components. All these 16 PF, we can put it in a four components. That four components, what he highlighted in the sense, common, unique, source and surface. For each one having all the traits of the common traits, unique traits and source traits and surface traits. Just to define what is the common traits. Common means most of the people having this some kind of common characteristics. So like honesty, aggressions and the cooperation. So this is called as a common traits found widely distributed. So most of the common people having this kind of common traits. In the case of the unique traits, you can find some kind of unique differences from the each individual. Whenever you find some of the people's unique personality, unique characteristics, that unique personality characteristics we may take it as a unique traits. So it not be common to all, only that particular person having some kind of unique differences, that we may take it as a unique traits. And each one having the surface traits as well as source traits. But in the case of surface traits, we can see from our eyesight, from his behavior, from our observation, we can understand what is the surface traits, like curiosity, dependability, and tactfulness. Normally, the surface traits are very obvious and can be easily to identify by others' people. From the people's action itself, we can easily to find out what is the surface traits. Like that surface trait, it may be visible openly from his characteristics. So that is called surface traits. Then the last one is called source traits. Actually, the source traits, it may helping to mold other traits. Like the last class also, we are talking about the cardinal traits, central traits, as well as the situation traits. So there also they can make it some kind of cardinal traits. It should be common. It should be like a father of all our traits. It may link with all our traits. So it may be source trait, but we could not see from, suppose you are the observer, you could not see the source trait of the each individuals immediately. And you could not read it properly. You could not read or you could not observe clearly what is the source traits. It's not visible. Actually, it's not less visible in the characteristics in the context of the each individuals. So like dominance emotional, because the dominance in the emotional, they cannot show regularly. So only the some kind of times only they can show it. Like situation based on the dimension. Right? That is why some kind of traits we cannot be observed very frequently. That is called source traits. So this is a thing. And he made the 16 PF theory, I already mentioned. But apparently, some of the personality questions also he made with his co-workers, with his followers. As well as the team of the cattle, what are the contributions they made in the same kind of personality pattern business? He made the theory high school personality questionnaire in the name of HSPQ. It may helping for the age 12 to 18 years. Previously, this is called high school personality questionnaire. Now, this is called as an adolescent personality questionnaire. So, the term is to be changed now. Previously, high school, now say adolescent. Then, similarly, the entire team of the cattle, they made it a different personality traits, children's personality questionnaire. The name is called CPQ. Then yearly school personality questionnaire, that short form is called ESPQ. Then preschool personality questionnaire, PSPQ. So like this, the same team of peoples, they worked for to generate this four parallel form of the personality questionnaire. But these four parallel form of question may help for to identify the school student's personality. So suppose you are teaching the adolescent, you can adopt this tool. If you are teaching the primary school, you can go with yearly school. If you are going with the preschool students, you want to observe, you can go with the preschool personality questionnaire. So like that, they already made different tools and different questionnaires. You can adopt based on the samples you are going to adopt. So this is a theory only made by 16 PF theory. Made by the great man of cattle. So I hope you don't have any doubt. So the main thing what he did in the case of the cattle lessons, he deviated, he having the different opinions compared to the Albert, because the Albert, he categorized only few groups only, or through camp conference only. That's why he believed that we cannot be categorize the people traits into a very small category, also very, very small common traits, the cognitive traits and all. That's why he moved to the 16 personality based factors, and he made this theory based on the factor analysis techniques. He ran the more than nearly 160 statement. All the 160 statement he ran with the use of the statistical analysis of factor analysis. Then he combined it to the 16 factors. That 16 factors only we discussed one by one previously. So I hope you don't have a doubt in this.